Mandibular first molar is the sixth tooth from the midline. Its tooth number in FDS system is 36 and 46, in universal system 19 and 30, and in zygmondy-palmar system the tooth number is 6 with appropriate quadrant brackets. It is the strongest tooth in the arch with 5 well-formed cusps and has a strong anchorage with 2 roots. Mandibular first molar develops from 5 developmental lobes, one lobe for each cusp. Like all molars, it is not a succedaneous tooth, and like maxillary first molar, it is also called the cornerstone of the arch. The function of mandibular molars is grinding. Mandibular first molar is the first permanent tooth to erupt in the oral cavity, as it erupts before maxillary first molar. Its age of eruption is 6 years. Coming to measurements, the cervico-occlusal measurement of the crown is 7.5 mm, the root length is 14 mm. Mesiodistal diameter of the crown is 11 mm and at cervix is 9 mm. The buccolingual diameter of the crown is 11.5 mm and at cervix is 9 mm. The curvature of the cervical line on the mesial side is 1 mm and on the distal side it is flat. The morphology of the tooth is studied under 5 aspects. Let us start with the buccal aspect. The outline form of the crown from the buccal aspect is trapezoidal, with its shorter parallel side towards the cervix and the longer side towards the cusps. From this aspect, all 5 cusps are visible. Mesiobuccal cusp, distobuccal cusp and the distal cusp are in the front. Among these, mesiobuccal cusp is the widest and the distal cusp is the smallest. All of these cusps are relatively flat, due to which tips of mesiolingual cusp and distolingual cusp are also visible. The mesial contact area of the tooth by which it contacts the second premolar is at the junction of occlusal third and middle third, whereas the distal contact area of the tooth by which it contacts the second molar is at the middle third. The cervical line is convex towards the roots. On the buccal surface, 2 grooves are present between the 3 cusps: mesiobuccal developmental groove between the mesiobuccal cusp and distobuccal cusp, and distobuccal developmental groove between distobuccal cusp and distal cusp. The distobuccal developmental groove is longer than the mesiobuccal developmental groove. A slight horizontal depression is seen in the middle third of the buccal surface. Due to this, a ridge is formed in the cervical third running mesiodistally, called the cervical ridge. Coming to the roots, the root trunk is of 3 mm, which then bifurcates into mesial root and distal root. Both roots have a distal curvature, and this curvature is more in the mesial root. Both the roots have developmental depressions on mesial and distal surfaces. This gives them an I-beam shape, which increases the anchorage of the roots. Next, the lingual aspect. The outline form features of the buccal aspect are seen in the lingual aspect as well. Only 3 cusps are visible from this aspect: 2 lingual cusps, mesiolingual cusp and distolingual cusp, and part of the distal cusp. The 2 lingual cusps are almost of equal mesiodistal width, but the cusp tips is highest of the mesiolingual cusp. The cuspal slopes of both the cusps meet at an obtuse angle of around 100 degrees. The cervical line is irregular. A groove is seen between the 2 cusps called the lingual developmental groove, which is shorter than both the buccal grooves. From the lingual aspect, both roots are visible. Interestingly, the root appears longer from the lingual aspect than the buccal aspect. This is because the cuspal slopes and the cervical line are more occlusal than on the buccal side. This makes the root trunk of 4 mm. Next, the mesial aspect. The outline form of the crown from the mesial aspect is rhomboidal. This is in continuation with all mandibular posterior teeth, which have a lingual tilt. 2 cusps are visible, the mesiobuccal cusp and the mesiolingual cusp. The buccal outline is convex with its height of contour at the cervical third due to the cervical ridge, and the lingual outline is convex with its height of contour in the middle of the middle third. The cervical line is convex towards the crown, and it is slightly occlusal in the lingual half than the buccal half. The mesial marginal ridge is seen confluent with the cuspal ridges of the mesial cusps. Only the mesial root is visible from this aspect, which is smooth and tapering towards the apex. The developmental depression is seen running along the long axis of the tooth. Coming to the distal aspect, the outline form of the crown is similar to that of the mesial aspect. As the distal side is smaller than the mesial side, more surfaces of the crown are visible from this aspect. Parts of all cusps are seen. The distal cusp is seen in front, which is slightly buccaled to the midline. The distal marginal ridge is short and the cervical line is flat. Coming to the roots, the distal root is in the front with parts of mesial root also being visible. A developmental depression may or may not be seen on the distal root.